Come once more, and today we are going to touch the core of what we are doing today. As a matter of fact, the topic we are going to look at is what is the best type of product to import, the best type of product to import and sell. So you must agree with me that if you want to do mini importation business, one of the greatest challenges you will have is finding the right type of product to import. So what is the best type of products to import? We're talking about products that when you import it, you should be able to sell it as fast as possible so that you can turn over your money and import another one. So what is the best type of products to import or to buy? A simple question but tricky at the same time. One of the most frequent questions I get from new importers is, what exactly should I import and how will I know it will sell? Now this question is the most important question to ask, especially if you are completely new to sales and business. The right product is one of the three P's of marketing. The three P's of marketing are people, product, and place. For people, you're talking about you and putting the right team in place. For the product, we're talking about selling the right product that solves a real problem. Then the place is talking about the location. That is where you market or sell the product. That is the three P's. A Little Bit of Marketing by Philip Kotler, the father of modern marketing. So you can see how important the right product is. It is said that if you do the best advertising and you have the best customer service, but without the right product, you will not be able to retain your customers. But if you have a poor advertising budget and a bad customer service, you can still retain your customers if you have the right product. That is how important product is. So back to the best types of products to buy. I will list what to look out for easier comprehension. So this applies especially to you, the beginner. If you just started mini importation, the first thing I would advise you to look out for is the weight. You have to understand that shipping a product is more expensive, or rather the price of shipping is proportional, directly proportional to the weight of the product. So the heavier the item is, the costlier the shipping will be. So personally, I import both heavy and lightweight items, but I recommend a lightweight item for a beginner. Note that shipping companies charge up to $5 a kilogram to ship items to Nigeria. So this varies, depends on your country and depends on the shipping company you are using. Some do $4, some do 3 points, and it also depends on the season, depends on the period you are buying it. Is it a holiday period? Is it a normal period? Is it, you know, Chinese holiday and all that? Except you got free shipping at a great price, just stick with lightweight items for a start. So the second thing you have to look out for is to import familiar products. The best products for you are the products you already know that it will sell in your place. So this applies especially to those who buy from a local market to resell. If you used to buy from a local market to resell, you'll find out that importing that particular or similar item from China will be cheaper with higher margin. So if you used to buy from Ariaria International Market in Aba, or from Alaba in Lagos, you know, it don't matter whichever market you used to buy from, you know, Ochanja, Onitsha, Kano, then you also realize that buying that particular item from China will be cheaper. So if you already have something you are selling, importing that similar thing will be the best thing for you. Then again, you have to The third point is you have to buy smaller quantity. This is a very applicable, especially if you are buying for the first time. If this is a product you are trying out for the first time, the right product is, the right thing to do is to buy smaller quantity. So you cannot completely rely on the pictures on the website to make a bulk purchase. I advise you to buy from 1 to 5 pieces first to actually test the product and know if you and your customers will love it. Some sellers will tell you that they can ship smaller quantities, especially in Alibaba.com. So try to convince them that it's just a test sample. You may pay more for it, but it's the safer thing to do. Okay? So the next thing, when you're talking about the right product, is I advise you, this is my advice, do not buy seasonal items. Don't buy items that sell depending on the season you are in as a starter. If you're already a pro, if you already have the established market, if you already have, you know, a customer base, then you can buy seasonal items. But for a start, I would advise you buy something you can always sell anytime. For example, don't invest in Christmas light or something seasonal. If you buy Christmas light, for example, then you must sell it from November to January. If you don't sell it within that period, you will have to wait till the next Christmas to sell it. So this is not healthy at all for a beginner. It applies to things of all seasons. Remember, you have to buy something you must eventually sell anytime. So the right product to buy is the one with great reviews. We've already looked at this before. Take your time and see what the customers that actually purchased the item say about it. I already showed you that you have to pick the item and look at these stars. This star shows you the reviews. 4.2, 5.0. Buy the ones with great review. Try to find out what the customers are saying. For example, here we have this product, and I will open it so that we can see what the customers are saying. Go to customer review. We've done this before if you watched our previous course. Go to customer review. See, 88% gave it 5 stars, which is fair. 1% gave it 8 stars. That is not enough. Actually, let's say go to those ones that gave it 5 stars and see what they are saying. Don't just stop there. Click on it to see what exactly they are saying. So it's loading, and before then also, okay, see, the box came in bad shape. The drone apparently looks good for the bag with protection that prevented damage to the device. It took more than 2 months for him to be held in customs. The seller was attentive and willing to collaborate. Okay, so you see, 5 star is not enough. 5 star doesn't mean there is no complaint, but it just means that the buyer, this guy is from Spain, the buyer is happy. He liked this. Seller answered all questions from Brazil. He took a little, but the drone arrived well packed. So they are saying the same thing. The seller, the posting is not too fast. You know, this is from Japan. Box arrived perfect, no scratches, no broken. You know, I think this is from Uruguay or something. The order came for 24 days. It's bad that it was not tracked. Sent me a gift bonus, for which very much thank you. So the seller was kind enough to send a gift bonus. So this is how you know it. Then for Alibaba, you may not see the star review, but you will see the seller star review, like we already said, 4.9, 4.5. So the best type of products to buy always should have great reviews. So buy lots of inventory. For the first time, buy this one, this one, this one, this one. You know, don't just buy one product. The best type of products to import are cheap products. Be careful not to buy expensive products. Like I showed you when we started, you can get products as cheap as anything. You can go to Alibaba and you can see $75 for the drone, You can get $7.99 depending on what you want to buy. But just know that you can even get products that are very cheap, $9, even $1, even less than $1. We have actually done this before, so I will refer you to this video and this course at stoplearn.com, how to source for products to import. It's very similar to the best type of products to import. Okay, so also the best type of products are rare products. You know, sometimes you don't want to go into the competition and all that. Monopoly is very held in business. What has worked for me all these years is buying rare but useful products. How do you know a rare product? When you see the product you think is rare, you have to search for it in your country's most popular e-commerce sites. For example, search for it in Jumia or Konga if you are in Nigeria. From there, you can see if another seller has it in his store and how many users, how many sellers have it. So if you want to sell, let's say, you know, anything like pregnancy pillow, go to Konga and check for it. Is there anybody selling it? Are they plenty? Are they many? Or is it just one person? If it is rare and you think you can market it, that is, you think there are people who need the same thing, then take the risk and import it. So if only less than 3 stores are selling it, check if you can compete with the price they are selling. If yes, go ahead and import it. So we did not mention any products, as you might have seen, but we are giving you a guideline, general guideline, because the truth is that there is no right product. It all depends on your market, depends on a lot of things, but these are the general guideline for you before you buy anything. These are for the best type of products or items to import. So in our next class, we are going to know how to know hot selling products. We are going to be more specific. How to know hot selling products. I would advise you to take this course also, how to know hot selling products. This is a more detailed course. This video is just a supplement to this course. You go to www.stoplearn.com to take this course. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe to see our other videos when they arrive, and thank you for listening to us.